Hello student, hope you are all well and stay safe at home. So this is the life science class of class 7 and our topic is flower. So all of us familiar with different types of flowers with different types of shapes and size and smell. Okay, so first we should know the definition of flower. What is flower? The flower is a specialized condensed branch bearing floral leaves and adapted to carry on sexual reproduction. I repeat, flower is a specialized condensed branch bearing floral leaves and adapted to carry on sexual reproduction. The flower is a modified shoot. Okay, flower is considered as a modified shoot. So next, we will be describe about the different parts of a complete flower. There are main four parts of a complete flower and they are: the first one is calyx, the second one is corolla, the third one is androecium, and the fourth one is gynoecium. Okay, so these are the main four holes of a complete flower. So first we will describe about the calyx. What is calyx? Calyx is the outer green hole of floral leaves. It consists of leaf-like structure known as sepals. Calyx is the outer green hole of floral leaves and it consists of leaf-like structure known as sepals. They are usually green in color. When the sepals are free, then it is called polysepalous. If the sepals are free, then it is called polysepalous. But if the sepals are jointed or united, then it is called gamosepalous. See? This portion is known as calyx. It is the outer green hole of floral leaves and normally it is green in color, as you can see. And these leaf-like structures, see, this leaf-like structure is known as sepals. Okay, when the sepals are free, like this, when the sepals are free, then it is known as polysepalous. But if the sepals are jointed like this, this portion is known as sepals, and if it is jointed, then it is known as gamosepalous. Example, polysepalous calyx or sepals, rose, and gamosepalous sepals, hibiscus or China rose. Okay. Next, then we should know the functions of the calyx. What is the function of the calyx? The primary function of the calyx is protective. It protects the inner floral parts from mechanical injury. It protects the inner floral parts from drying out in excessive heat, rain, etc. It also protects from excessive cold, rain. Green sepals perform the photosynthesis function. Colored sepals may also attract insects like petals and pollination. The primary functions of the calyx is protective or protection. In bud stage, it protects the inner floral parts from mechanical injury. It protects the inner floral parts from excessive heat, rain, etc. Green sepals perform the photosynthesis function and colored sepals also attract the insects like petals and perform pollination. Okay, so these are the function of the calyx. Next part is corolla. Corolla is the second part and it is leafy colored second hole of a flower. The individual members of the corolla are known as petals. See, these are known as corolla and this portion is known as corolla and the individual member of the corolla is known as petals. These are the petals. Okay, the corolla is polypetalous when the petals are free. If the petals are free, then it is known as polypetalous. But if the petals are jointed, then it is known as gamopetalous. If the petals are free like this, then it is known as polypetalous. But if the petals are not free or if the petals are jointed together, then it is known as gamopetalous. Okay. Now function, what is the function of the corolla? Due to its bright color, sweet scent, corolla attracts insects for pollination. It also protects the inner floral parts in bud stage. Okay, due to its sweet scent, color, it attracts the insects and perform for pollination. It also protects the inner bird's floral parts in bird stage. Okay, so this is the functions of the corolla. The next part is androecium. Androecium is the hole of male parts of a flower. It is the third hole and it is the male parts of a flower. In hibiscus or China rose, inside the corolla, see, this portion is known as corolla. Inside the corolla, a long slender like structure is there. See, a long slender like structure is there. Okay, and its tip or the apical part come out of flower. It is the apical part that come out of the flower. Slightly below the tip, some fine structures are attached. These are the stamens, which consist of two parts. The one is filament and the another one is anther. Okay, this is the androecium is the third hole of the flower and it is the male part of a flower. In hibiscus or China rose, inside the corolla, a long slender like structure is there. Okay, and its tip or apical portion is come out of the flower. Okay, slightly below the tip, some fine structure is attached. This is the fine structure is attached below the tip. This is the tip. Below the tip, some fine structure is attached, and these are the stamens. This part is known as stamens, and this stamen part is made up of two parts. One is filament and another is anther. See, if you see the structure, these are the stamen part, and the stamen is made up of two parts. This long part is known as filament, and this part is known as anther. This long slender like structure is known as filament, and this portion, this sac like portion, is known as anther. So the rod like lower portion of a stamen is known as filament, and the sac like pollen bearing apical portion is known as anther. The pollen sacs are filled up in this portion. The pollen sacs are filled up with minute dust like structure called pollen grains. The pollen sacs are filled up with minute dust like structures called pollen grains. So this is a stamen. And the stamen is made up of two parts. The first part, the slender like structure, long slender like structure, is known as filament, and the sac like structure is known as anther. The pollen sacs are filled up with minute dust like structure known as pollen grains. Okay, and the stamens made the androecium portions. Okay, so now we should know the function of the androecium. What is the function of the androecium? Stamens produce pollen grains or microspores in which a miniature male gamete is formed. Stamen produce pollen grains or microspores in which a miniature male gamete is formed. The male gamete formed and take part in the process of fertilization. Therefore, stamen can be called male sex organ of a flower. So, stamen produce pollen grains or microspores in which a miniature male gamete is formed that take part in the process of fertilization. That's why stamen can be called male sex organ of a flower. Okay. Next, the next part and the last part is known as gynoecium or pistil. It is also an essential hole of a flower, and it is the fourth hole of a flower, and it is called the female reproductive part of a flower, and may be composed of one or more carpels. A carpel has three distinct parts. Gynoecium composed of one or more carpels. Okay, and the carpel has three distinct parts. The first one is stigma. The second one is style and the ovary. See, this is this portion. This portion is known as carpel, and the gynoecium is made of one or more than one carpels. And this carpel has three distinct parts. The first one is stigma, means this portion is stigma, and second portion is style, this portion, this long portion, and this portion, this sac-like portion is ovary. Okay, so gynoecium is the fourth hole or the last hole of a flower, and it is also an essential hole of a flower because it is known as the female sex organ of a flower. Okay, so gynoecium is made up of more than one carpels, and a carpel is made up of three distinct part. The first one is known as stigma, the second one, the long part is known as style, and the last portion, see, this portion is known as stigma, this portion is known as style, and this portion is known as ovary. Okay, in hibiscus, if you slowly remove the outer covering of a middle thread like structure, means this part, if you see this part, if you slowly remove the outer covering of the middle thread like portion, you can see the carpel portion, and the carpel portion is made up of three distinct parts, and you can also see the three distinct parts like stigma, style, and ovary. Okay, the solen oval basal part, see, the solen oval basal part is known as ovary. Okay, the solen basal part is known as ovary. Okay, the tip with five dots like structure is called stigma. This is the five dot like structure, and this is known as stigma. Okay, and the connective part between the stigma and the ovary, the connective part, this part is connection, this part is connective part. Okay, the connective part between the stigma and the ovary, and this portion is known as style. Okay, so then the solen, I repeat, the solen oval basal part is known as ovary. The tip with five dots, it's known as stigma, and the connective part between the stigma and the ovary is known as style. Stigma is the terminal end of the style and receive pollen grains. It receives pollen grains. It is the terminal end. It is the terminal end of the style and receive pollen grains. Okay, it may be knob-like or slightly elongated or funnel-shaped structure. It may be knob-like or slightly elongated or funnel-like structures. Okay, function, what is the function of the gynoecium? Gynoecium produces ovum and ovules, which after fertilization produce fruits and seeds respectively. Okay, ovules develop within ovary after fertilization, and ovule is transformed into a seed, and the ovary transform into the fruit. Ovules develop within the ovary. This part is known as ovary. This part is known as ovary. Okay, ovule develops within the ovary after fertilization, and ovule is transformed into a seed, and the ovary transformed into the fruit. Ovules develop in this part. After fertilization, ovule transform into the seed, and the ovary transform into the fruit. Okay, so these are the four main parts of a flower. The first one is calyx, the second one is corolla, the third one is androecium, and the fourth one is gynoecium. Okay, androecium and gynoecium are together called essential hole, as they take part in the reproduction. So, and the next part is complete flower and incomplete flower, the types of flower. There are two types of flowers, and the first one is complete flower and the second one is incomplete flower. What do you mean by complete flower? When a flower bears all the four holes, then it is known as complete flower. Example, China rose. Okay, when a flower bears all the four holes, then it is called complete flower. Okay, a complete flower has all the four holes, but incomplete flowers one or more hole are absent. Example, gourd, okay, or pumpkin. So these are the types of flower. The first one is complete and the second one is incomplete. Okay, so today up to this, and the next portions will be discussed in the next video. Thank you.